Grandma, she's better than that.
No, see, I'm copying him.
Oh, you got a fish.
It's not a freaking fish you got. Again.
Okay.
Pretty.
Can you tell what everything is?
I can tell that.
Some paying attention, Rachel?
Catches in there.
Mike and I and
I'm going to put that there.
That's a nice area down there.
Let's highlight my pipe.
Don't be rude.
I've already made it once tonight.
I
didn't do that for you.
Yep, killed one.
Okay.
Come up to the tree with it.
Hey, got
you.
So, you think you got some?
I don't know.
Be on the little mansion back.
They didn't just stand like that.
Boom, boom, boom!
How'd you happen to find out about all this?
Pardon?
How'd you find out about all this?
The second time
we knew it was up here, but the Civil War guy in Boise, they have the game comes alive. And so we go to that every year.
Too many legs.
You have a good day.
Is it you guys in the world?
Had a rock yesterday, didn't know, and it actually blew up, and a piece of coal hit me in the hand, or a piece of rock. I was a little surprised, needless to say.
Ow.
Bose, I have retired to the chamber, the library, to write you a short letter. We are very dull here today in consequence of our troops having all left us except a sort of frontier guard. About a week ago, the approach of Jin Jerry with 6,000 men induced our small army to leave. Jerry came into town but remained only an hour on his retiring. Our troops came back, but yesterday moved again, for what reason we know not. A great fight is said to be in progress, and that may have something to do with it. Our boys, no doubt, have again been in danger. God grant that their lives have been spared. Our suspense of several days will be dreadful. I have had three regiments of cavalry on the Springdale farm for a week, including that cold spell. The havoc in my barn will tell the tale of many a day, but we must all bear our share of the burden. We availed ourselves of the last cold spell to kill and pack our pork. Our hogs were in good order. Three in the pen at the home were very nice and weighed about 140 each, so that yours, I owe you $25, which I will keep.
Stuff, but he would read that up for a part of the yarn. But then they started learning how to run their own factories and pick the wind off again, which we're good at.
Yeah.
Awesome. His name is.
ammunition. So they said to the president, well, see, General Ripley over here, he doesn't want these weapons. And Lincoln said, fire Ripley. So they retired him, brought in a new guy, and from then until the end of the war, they issued 95,000 of these.
Wow.
The other two are single-shot percussion weapons. This is a Sharps. This is a falling block breech loader. You open it up, use a combustible cartridge, which is made of linen, has the powder in it and the bullet attached. You put the cartridge in the breech, you close it, then you have to cap it with a percussion cap. These caps are carried in the small pouch on the belt. You got a cap, cap it, and you're ready to shoot. Because it was a single shot, and you had to use a percussion cap, you could only fire about 6 rounds a minute, which was double the rate of fire of the infantry rifle. But still, it was pretty slow. Spencer can fire 7 shots in 20 seconds.
I'm not surprised.
So you can see what kind of a weapon they had instead of these two. Generals wrote about this weapon. They said things, you know, like as I mentioned, but they testimonial after testimonial came in to Spencer about how he had one regiment armed with this and he was worth 3 or 4 regiments of the enemy.
Stop.